You're in time for Big Issue, still rush hour. Now we're talking, we were having a conversation about food in the city. People are worried about the hygiene of the food that is available. In Karamoja, it's a different story. People are dying from starvation, according to reports coming in. And we are seeing that local authorities are calling on government to do something. The area leaders are also calling for immediate food relief. Vivian Kamsime is here with me, and we want to take a look at what's happening exactly. How are these stories happening, and what are we missing as journalists? A very good morning once again.
Good morning.
You went and had breakfast on me.
No, not really. I've actually been running a bit of errands here and there. Good morning, viewer. If you just joined us, you are welcome to our show. This is a big issue going on right here. Lynn, it's very sad what is happening in Karamoja.
That's for sure.
Very sad moment for people in Karamoja. Mm. And a number of issues are going on there. They are not only starving to death, they had insecurity a few months back.
Yes.
Then we saw that disarmament program rolling in there to curb the cattle rustling that was going on. We've had weather challenges. It's now droughts, which is bringing in the hunger right now. There's malnutrition, the food crisis that is going on due to this hunger crisis, or the dry season, the droughts that has been on for a while.
Yeah.
I don't know if you have noticed that we have not had rains for a while.
Yes, that's true. But you see, Karamoja in itself is a very, very sensitive area, and it's very delicate. It has had issues over the years, and Vivian,
this
we
is
have
the first time it is happening.
It's not the first time.
Yes.
We have the Moroto woman representative for Moroto district, that is Atiang Stella. She's joining us online. A very good morning to you, honorable, and welcome to the show.
Yes, good morning.
So stories and reports coming in indicate that there's hunger and people are dying from starvation in Karamoja. What do you tell us today?
Good morning.
I'm sorry, honorable, I'm failing to pick you well. Let's break a little bit and get you properly so we can. You're breaking, your network is a bit unstable.
Her line is not exactly clear.
Yeah, her line is not very clear. Just give us a minute, we'll get back to you. We are still talking Karamoja and hunger. Vivian, I'm told people have died, and it's a very sad situation for us as a country.
Yes. Very sad situation going on there. About 70 people have already lost their lives. The MPs actually said, is she online?
I think she's back. Stella, is that you? Honorable.
Yes.
Yes, please go ahead. I think we can hear you loud and clear now. Yes, yes. Okay.
Yes.
So, honorable, What has government done? Have you, as leaders, alerted government or the necessary or the authorities in charge? Have you talked to them and told them of the problem that is on ground?
Yes, we are actually calling government and informing them what is happening. We actually have reported on the gang situation in the area. Mm-hmm. Government has tried to intervene. However, the intervention is not reasonable enough because the intervention was really good. But the relief force that has been given is not reasonable enough to push people for some money.
Okay. So, Honorable, what do you think would be reasonable in a situation like now? And when, would it have to be very urgent, like today? And how do you think government can actually move on right now?
If government can allocate some money to buy food, at least that can be given a family to push them for a month, as they also try to plan for other companies.
That's very right. Honorable, you did mention that something has been done, but it's not enough. What is required exactly? Is it food? Is it? Do you want people to come on ground as a government and deliver food physically? Or, as you say, there is need for more money. And to do what money? Because people, we know corruption is rampant. We cannot trust people
plus
with money.
Plus also the drought situation, it requires, because the drought is not stopping right now.
Right.
So what is going to happen when people have to plant again? Honorable, what measures are going to be ensured that this food is actually given to the people who need it? And is your community organized in such a way that once this food comes, it will get to them directly?
Actually, Honorable, before you answer that, there have been reports also that the communities are not as welcoming. They're not as cooperative as required.
Not cooperative, but welcoming.
In terms of cooperating, when they need the assistance, they're a bit held back with. They believe so much in their communities, and so it becomes hard for relief to come in.
No, I don't think that is true. Mm. Yes, the Kalamujongs are so cooperative, especially in times of situations like this. It's just a matter of.
So, Honorable, there are reports that there are deaths there. Do you know the number of people who have actually died?
I can't be sure of the number of people that have died, but I believe in my city, I get reports at least two every week.
And how long has this been going on? Just to be precise.
It is long. Now it has been growing because the community is not able to affect anything.
So why are you coming up now? We could have started the call at the start of
Much earlier, because there are forecasts on how the, first of all, the weather is going to do. And then we also had that disarmament program going on where I think activities within the community were actually disrupted.
Yeah.
So a number of problems, honestly, could have been...
avoided if you had maybe come up earlier than this.
No, we have not just come. We came to the government, but that's why the government is not taking the report. That is not reasonable enough now, because this is the third government taking the report, not reasonable. That is why we are asking the government to increase the funding to food that is taken to the region to save the economy from this harsh. Right.
Honorable, besides calling on the authorities, especially the central government, to come in and deal with this drought, what measures as an MP have you been doing on ground to see that you help your electorate in this time?
We have been advocating for them, and we have been encouraging them to kill the land, to fight. So that if in case they can invest and be able to survive in their own usual.
That's quite interesting because some MPs came out to say that they have been buying food with their own salaries and have already depleted it. I'm wondering how long that can actually go on because, like you said, an MP's job is basically advocacy and coming up with some of these issues in society to the center stage. Yes, we hope that a number of measures and the agencies are actually going to come through for you. And we keep praying for Karamoja. I think that's very important.
Thank you.
Right. Thank you very much, Honorable, for your time. And hopefully you can give us more details as and how the development goes when you meet the government and what reply they'll give you very soon. We wish you the very best and hope everybody gets some help. Thank you very much. All right, that was Moroto District Woman Member of Parliament at Young, Stella, telling us what's happening on ground in the Karamoja region. It's very absurd that we have reached such a point.
Very sad. But Lynn, what's going on there is very sad.
Again, my problem, Vivian, terrible. Is that Karamoja has been at the center of trouble.
Yes.
Insecurity.
Yes.
We have cattle rustling that has been going on for a long time. Prolonged drought is not news to them. It's been going on for years. Question is, for how long will that area continue suffering?
And you know what is interesting is that Karamoja is also a tourism hub.
Exactly.
They also have minerals of gold that are being mined right there. Mm-hmm. I don't know whether the community is actually sensitized about these minerals. How are they involved in this whole activity? How does it benefit them as a community? Their wildlife, how are they living side by side with them? And the tourism, how do they earn from it? Because when you go to other places, like in Fort Poto, which is the tourism city in this country, you find that the locals there are the tourist guides.
Yeah.
They make food, they are the chefs. They those who can afford actually have accommodation units that actually house people. You know, as individuals in the community, to actually help them cope with their situation. I like Fort Poto because, yes, it's a laid-back town. You might get in there and be like, wow, the town is sleeping. But a lot is going on because everyone is in their backyard trying to do something here and there with that tourism.
That's true.
So how does the government actually get to sensitize the people in Karamoja on how they are going to cope? Because those are the activities that they have to do. They have a lot of droughts. So certainly sadly, we can see that the digging is not working out.
But you see, Karamoja, like, I, well, the MP rightfully, respectfully declined to agree that the community in Karamoja is, because of the formation, because of the, they're nomads, okay?
Yes.
So that culture is deeply embedded in that community. So it's hard for them. There's a lot you need to navigate.
And you know the thing about herding is that, and I think that's why they keep moving from place to place. Because you have to feed the animal, you know?
Yeah.
It has life. You have to feed it. You need to take care of it when it's sick. You have to give it drinking water. Like the requirements of an animal. Eh?
So it's I think
quite enormous.
Government needs to, you know, do more in the Karamoja region, especially sensitized people.
Yes, just like they did a lot in their mid-90s and early 90s to bring civilization to that area.
That's true.
And the disarmament program then, which they have re-embarked on because of the new cases of cattle rustling.
Mm.
So let's wait and see how government is going to tackle this one.
I'm sure there's a lot they're going to do, and they're
yes,
already
because
doing
we have
a
disaster and preparedness ministry.
Yeah,
that should be taking up that issue.
They're doing quite a lot, and I think over the years we have seen growth in the region there,
yes.
As you can see on your screen. There's growth, really. I mean, we've grown from a point where they used not to dress up at all. Now they are, you know, pretty dressed. So we are hoping that this hunger and starvation problem, because there are stories going around, we're seeing photos of the elderly and, of course, the children dying of hunger. And it's not
very
fair.
Sad stories coming.
Very
sad pictures. And it's quite painful because these people are human beings like us. They are part of the country, just like we are. They belong with us. And like we said, they too should share on the national cake.
Mm, absolutely. So local authorities are actually urging government to act, and their members of parliament are calling for immediate food relief as soon as possible, as you've heard from the Honorable Member of Parliament, District Woman Representative Moroto. She says they're going to sit as a committee and find solutions to this problem. We hope it can be resolved soon and sort all these problems. But again, I still insist somebody needs to work on that community, especially in dealing with human-to-human interactions, because that's the beginning. You interact with them and tell them this is a problem and this is how we're going to solve it. Can you be cooperative enough?
I think that is government sensitization.
Yeah.
Government should come up
with sensitization
programs. And generally advise them on the activities going on in their area right there and see how they can actually impact households, households, and enable them to actually be productive and come up with ways of actually taking care of their homes and feeding them. Because, yes, you know, time and time again, even from other societies, we've all had communities that had certain activities that are major to them, but then were able to shift away from them if they're not actually giving solutions. So I think, of course, the rearing cattle is a good thing. It can be profitable. It is a good activity, economic activity. But as far as Karamoja right now is concerned, they need grass, first of all. Remember, the season is not a good one. It's very dry there. The drought is on. It is scorching hot.
Yeah, that's
so
true.
So you're asking yourself, where are the cattle going to feed?
I mean, if cattle can't find grass at this point,
yes,
which they heavily rely on, where are they going to find food in it?
Plus also the water dries up.
Yes, yeah,
it's a drought season.
It's a drought season in Karamoja. It's also a bit sunny everywhere around and very heavy. So we hope relief can be given, and of course we'll get more details on what's happening. As you can see on the screen, the committee from the Karamoja region
community
was meeting to find solutions to the problem. It's really escalating, considering that there's the disarmament process going on. Because if there's disarmament, then it means there's a lot. Prolonged drought, they have poor harvests. I mean, it's a whole lot of problems.
A number of issues. Like I mentioned earlier, a number of issues are actually going on already. There's always been this malnutrition going on.
Yeah.
Because of the kind of things they feed on. Do we feed on only blood Do we only eat meat from the cows? You know, you need fruits, you need vegetables, you need proteins.
You need carbohydrates.
Exactly what I'm talking about. So let's see how situation turns around.
Absolutely. It's a story we are following up, of course, and we'll definitely update you on the latest when and how those come in. We'll take a break right now. When we return, Rush Hour Talk.
According to the Napark District Woman MP Faith Nakut, by 8th July, Napark District had registered 46 deaths to starvation, with 2,181 households in fear of death over the same due to the dire state of famine that is ravaging Karamoja sub-region. Nakut and other legislators from Karamoja have come out to cry to the world to move fast and rescue the people of Karamoja before the death toll widens.
During recess, I managed to visit together with my colleagues, we moved in the region of Karamoja to mobilize our people for peace. But during that tour, we got many people at the verge of starvation. In my district, I visited some sub-counties, some parishes like Nagule Angolol. I found when they had just buried a family, a whole family died because they had no food. So I came back really heartbroken because I never imagined we would get to this level. I knew we would normally face disasters, but I never imagined that we would be in a level where people die because they are lacking food.
I want all of us to pray for Karamoja and stand with the people of Karamoja. The situation in Karamoja is not really good. People are dying in silence. There are a lot of challenges that Karamoja is undergoing now in this 21st century. Because this is what we witnessed in 1980s, in 1979, 1980s, 1985. When you go to Karamoja right now, there are a lot of issues that happen in Karamoja. Insecurity is eating up Karamoja. The disarmament is going on in Karamoja. The hunger situation is invading Karamoja. The weather situation is not also good in Karamoja. And so many other problems.
Nakut, who broke down while addressing a press conference at Parliament, noted that they have depleted their salary as MPs to buy food for the most affected households due to slow response by the government.
The needs are so immense. I have tried even exhausting salary. It has not even reached 0.001% of the need. So I need support, seriously. No, it has to happen now. If you care about humanity and you're watching and listening, please, it's time to take action. We can explain other things, not this one.
Karamoja MPs attribute the current famine to gross insecurity in the region that disabled families from settling for cultivation and rustling that left farmers with no animals on top of the dry spell that hit the region.
Before, people of Karamoja, when there is hunger, they used to go to Teso Sebe, Abim, they used to go to Karenga and some other areas, but right now they can't go there just because of insecurity. You have heard that the neighbors also are being invaded, like the Teso and Sebe, where people used to go to suffer. So you cannot go to the neighborhood.
The consistent insecurity for 3 years has made it difficult for crop farmers, for livestock farmers to do anything. So it's really largely responsible. If your cows were stolen, and yet normally our people rely on their cows, their milk, to survive in a year like this when there is no harvest. Because milk is, you know, is a complete meal.
Mary Gino, the chairperson Kabong District, says people have started eating grass in the district due to lack of food. He expressed fears that more elderly people are likely to die of starvation because they cannot run to other regions for greener pastures.
The disabled, people living with disabilities, these people are going because when the young people are going to the centers to survive, they are left behind together with the children and there's no food. People have resorted to heating is some grass which I only heard that people ate it in 1980 when there was famine in Karamoja. There is a grass called Eududu, where it is very tiny and you have to really like the size, almost millet, but also tinier than millet. You have to scratch, harvest a lot, scratch, but in the end you get a little bit and grind it into porridge. That's what people are feeding on, something which has never been heard of in Uganda. And interestingly, this country is a blessed country. Don't know God just put it here and put it as Ugandans. But in this 21st century, we are witnessing this happening in Karamoja, and nobody's talking about it, including the media, hardly goes to cover such things.
Now these legislators want the government to table a supplementary request in parliament to find funds to rescue the people of Karamoja with adequate relief aid.
A family was given 2 cups of beans and a small container, nomi container of portion. That is just a meal for a day. What about tomorrow? What about the next day? It means that you're going to eat today. The next day probably you would have some calories to move for that day. But the third day, you go back to zero.
Report by Fred Kajui for the news at Parliament.